You can make a lot of cool things with an Arduino, but should you buy the official Arduino starter kit or a cheaper kit with more sensors like the Elegoo? Is it a good gift for kids? Which is the best starter kit for you? Let's find out now on Geek Detour. 3 years ago, I wanted to build a robotic finger to push the iPad's button and take photos of the screen, and the official Arduino kit came with pretty much everything I needed to make my robot. At the time, I didn't know much about Arduinos, besides it is a small board with a tiny computer that you can program and make cool machines with sensors and motors. I had a lot to learn, and the official kit came with a book. But let's first open both kits and then we can talk about the book and the CD. The official Arduino kit comes in a cardboard box, beautifully printed, listing all the components and guided projects, and it's available in different language versions. In Europe, it is quite easy to buy it in any of the languages, but in the US, I could only find it in English or Spanish, like mine. I'll put links in the description. The first thing you'll get in the box is the book, and it's a great book. Very well explained, illustrated, and easy to understand. The small electronic pieces come in this box. Transistors, capacitors, a bunch of resistors, diodes, connectors,
a buzzer, MOSFETs, potentiometers, push buttons, light sensors, a motion sensor, a bunch of LEDs,
and more. Even if you don't know anything about these things, the book really takes you by the hand. Every project will introduce a couple of different components. You can read how they work and see how they should be connected in that project. As you go through every project of the book, you will use all components that come in the kit. The components are connected together in a small breadboard. You also get a bunch of jump wires already cut in different lengths. The USB cable in this kit is about 5 feet. Very nice cable. One of my favorite parts is this blue LCD screen. It looks super cool, retro, high-tech. Also, a DC motor to spin things, and a servo motor that you can control the angle. And the most important part is an original Arduino Uno board, the heart and brain of every project. Finally, it comes with a plastic base to keep things tied together, and several cardboard cutout pieces that should make the project more fun and engaging. This is something I only saw in the official startup kit so far. Now, let's open the Elegoo Super Starter Kit that comes in a sturdy plastic box case with real hinges and locks. It doesn't come with a book, it comes with a CD. Don't worry if your computer doesn't have a CD reader, you can download everything from Elegoo's website. We will talk about what comes in the CD in a moment. Here's a visual list of all components, and I will separate the extra parts that come in this kit, but not in the official Arduino starter kit. First, the Elegoo Uno board. This should be technically identical to an Arduino Uno board, but brings an extra feature. The pins are identified everywhere, in the board and also in the connector on both sides. This is cool. This is a prototype expansion module that you plug on top of an Arduino board as a shield, and you can either use this tiny solderless breadboard or solder your components directly on the board for a more durable prototype. This is very nice for more advanced users, and it doesn't come with the official Arduino starter kit. A 9-volt battery, I don't remember if the official Arduino kit comes with one. A bunch of LEDs. Oh, two buzzers. This one makes beeps on its own. And the other buzzer is like a speaker. You must create a frequency, like the one that comes in the official kit. The age bridge is the same, and this is an 8-bit shift register that is a very cool addition. The ball switch motion sensor is the same. The two transistors are... let's test here. Oh, it's normal NPN transistors. Here, this kit could be better. The official Arduino kit brings 5 transistors and 2 MOSFETs. The DC motor is very similar, but the fan with flexible baits is an extra. It's nice. But it is a simplification. In the official kit, the motor is used to spin a cardboard zoetrope, which is a more interactive, interesting interactive project than the fan blade. A bunch of jumper wires, but these have plastic endings, a bit more fancy than the official kit. The USB cable is quite short. The official kit has a better cable than this one. The LCD module is exactly the same, two lines of 16 characters. This infrared control is a cool extra. There should be a receiver somewhere here in the box. The joystick is also a cool extra. It has two potentiometers and one switch. Very cool. And this is something super nice that should be mandatory in every Arduino kit. A stepper motor and its driver module. A shame the official kit doesn't bring one. This type of motor you can control exactly how much movement you want in tiny steps. The connector clip for the 9-volt battery. An ultrasonic sensor, also an extra feature, a nice extra. 5 push buttons, 2 photoresistors and a thermistor. A bunch of resistors. And I have a complaint about the Elegoo resistors. They have a blue body and I simply cannot identify the colors of the rings. Not only in this kit, I also have an Elegoo resistors kit, which is an amazing value, but has the same problem. Once I take a resistor out of its bag and mix them, it's game over. You need to measure them. Please, Elegoo, this is how a resistors should be. Always. All right, a tiny servo motor, just like the ones for RC models, but these are so small, only 9 grams. Comes with a few horns arms too, pretty much like the official kit. A temperature and humidity sensor, lots of real life projects use this one, and it's an extra. Just like this relay, super useful to control a lot of things. But there are more practical relay modules out there, like the one I used in my fingerbot to control my Canon. Found it, the infrared receiver. A 4-digit 7-segment display and a single-digit 7-segment display, both cool extras. Potentiometer, DuPont wires, this is super cool, I wish it came with more of them. The breadboard is the big one, twice the size of the official kit. And finally, a power supply module to plug on the breadboard, and you can choose between 5 volts or 3 volts for each rail independently. You should power it from this connector. The USB is output only. You should not try to power it from the USB. And I discovered that reading the datasheet, of course. So, let's talk about it. The Elegoo kit doesn't bring a book, it brings a CD. A lot of new computers now don't have CD drives, but even if you have one, you should go to the Elegoo website and download the new material from there. The tutorials on my CD look a bit amateur, but the new tutorials look more polished, pretty much like a book. Another important thing that is on the CD and in the download is a folder called Datasheet, with datasheet documents for every component on the kit. If you're a beginner, it might look overwhelming, but if you are a more advanced user making your own projects, this is super handy. Let's see the ultrasonic sensor's datasheet. You can learn a lot about how it works. For example, the minimum distance it can detect is 2 centimeters, and even though you won't be able to hear it working, your cat or dog probably will. Datasheets are awesome, and Elegoo made it really easy for us. You can also have the datasheets for the official Arduino kit on their website. Let's imagine you just made the thermometer experiment and you want to know more about the sensor. Here you have it, the minimum and maximum temperatures and so much more. Anyway, the biggest advantage of the official Arduino kit is the book. And I'm not just talking about being an actual physical paper book, which I love, but the text is really well written. The graphics are very clear and it makes so much easier to look side by side and avoid mistakes. Also, the programming is super well explained. I mean it. The entire code is covered in details. So, here's the deal. I really like the Elegoo products and their kits are loaded with cool components and modules. If you already have some electronics and programming knowledge, these kits are great kits. Maybe you already have a project in mind, and this kit brings most, if not everything, of what you need to jump right on it, with a great price. The official Arduino kit is pricey, I know. It is a much smaller kit, but if you look at it as an educational product, it is very well made. The book is great and the whole thing feels premium, not just a box with stuff. It makes a great present. Now, if you're a parent like me, you might be thinking, is Arduino something my kid will enjoy? It is not targeted for kids younger than 8. I know a few parents got disappointed, you know. Oh, my kid loves computer, but barely touched the kit. It is hard to predict. Kids can be quite impatient and might rush things and connect something incorrectly. And if it doesn't work, they simply abandon it. When I was a kid, I would have loved a kit like this. I was really into chemistry sets, physics sets. I loved science books and I followed the instructions of experiments. I was a nerdy kid. The difference is that now, being geeky is cool. I just remembered, Elegoo has a robot car kit with sensors to follow a line in the floor or to avoid obstacles, infrared remote control, or being controlled with an app on the phone. This kit is more in the science toy category rather than a set of experiments. I think kids can have lots of fun with it, at least once it is assembled. There are links for the kits in the description, and if you have any question, please leave a comment. I read everything. I am also finishing a kind of big Arduino project eventually, so subscribe, and thanks for watching.